And welcome back to Kid Raw Plays Terraria. Last time, we returned to the world with a brand new spanking beard. And with this beard we reclaimed the house, and I'm just adding more and more stories to it. Even though the only NPC we've got to habit this place is the guide. And, spoiler alert, he's here all the time. It's not like he's anywhere else in the game. When you build your first house and head to a mining expedition at night, that's the guy who's gonna sleep in your bed, sit in your sofa, and poop in your toilet. First grade joke. So we'll chop down this tree. Make the ground a little bit less wonky. I'll check my audacity here. Yep, I'm still recording. That's good. That's always good. Now what to do? What we really want to do is get a bit of stuff. And that cave could be a good idea to try and get some of that. I'll plunk this down and make a bit of a shelter here. And we'll make it wide like that. Just because. We'll grab some of the stone. Just because. I like using stone when I build stuff. But this series won't be about building. Of course I might make something out of that place. It's only a wonky wooden building. And I don't like how it turns out. So at least I'll use stone for the cellar. Oh yeah, I've been on that cave. Let's just snatch this and be on our way. What I want to know is... this might be a death wish once again, but I want to know if anything's accessible in the place where our earlier character died. I don't think it is, but I could be wrong. No, it isn't. This is the place where we died. We lost the boomerang. And I don't really know why I'm heading further. This is really a death wish. I love the jungle music, by the way. I want to see if I can find some surface chest, maybe. Likely not. I'll head back at the first sight of something hostile. Or I'm rather scared. Oh shit, it's a vulture. And another one? They keep spawning. We need to make a run for the safe hole. Not risking it this time. Oh shit, it's the pinky. Fuck! God damn it! I'm out. No way. Son. You ain't coming here. Not this time. Not today. Maybe I can slaughter them still. I mean, this guy here, you see him. Pinky. 150 health points. Last I played, I recall it dropped some... one gold in cash. Oh shit, it's a bat. I didn't even realize. So they drop quite a bit of... Oh shit, they can access this place! Walling myself off. No way in heck. Already so low. I think it went away though. I'm taking so many unnecessary risks here. I mean, I thought I could check the place out. You know, see what I can see. Find maybe... a lucky chest or a spawn of minerals into the surface. But no, shit got real. You saw that. I was trying to make it back at the site of first hostile thing, but there was no hostile thing there. Only thing that was, however, was the two damn vultures that spawned right as I left the screen. So that's a bit of a bummer, if I say so myself. Jump our way up and... it's still there! It really wants to punish us for our... foolish mistakes. But we won't let him. Because I'm a tough-as-nails pioneer of wilderness who... I just... my vocabulary isn't big enough to chain these fancy words together. I'm a spelunking pioneer of adventurous insights. Let's leave it at that. I know that means effing nothing. But I got to keep talking. After all, I am a real person playing a video game. Filming it on YouTube for no apparent reason. God damn it, it's that psycho bat once again. We'll cover the ground with wood there. Make our way up the hill. Try to head to our house. And I don't know what to do to this guy. Maybe he'll go away once we get far away from the jungle. I hope. Maybe I can surface. Just maybe. No. No way he's going to let me go up. He's just making these scouting runs from here to here.
Hey, is that guy surfaced already? No? Well, I guess I'll be off. I'll be back later.
That funny voice. It wasn't funny, it's obnoxious. It's the way my old history teacher used to sound. Yeah, we're doing this. We're going mighty fine. Oh, he sent his lackeys to do his job for him. So that's the way it is. Oh, he's still there. Why can't he just leave? I mean, we're far away from his home now. This ain't no jungle. What the heck is he doing? If we had that boomerang or a spear, I think I could dispatch of him quite easily. But I don't, because I went and did a stupid mistake and died. And almost died again. But this time we're wiser, we're tunneling through like a true dwarf. Speaking of dwarves, my character kind of looks like one. Short, stumpy, robust, bearded, burrowing butt kicker. We'll just keep plunking the torches down. We have no gel, so we'll run out eventually. But I think we can access this cave with the chest in it and head to our house from the hill. See, we're planning ahead. It's gonna work out. Too bad we lost all the stars with the earlier character. You know, the falling stars dropping in the night. When you get 10 of those, I think, could be the wrong number, you can combine them. And once you combine and use them, you'll get mana. I think it's 20 mana per star. You know, the mana appears here. We have none. The bat is still there. Don't even know if it's the same one. Could be. Maybe not. Anyways, these tunnels, they do make it a bit easier to go around. Even though digging is a chore in this game. I don't really like it how you have to manually dig through these tree blocks. Maybe add an alternative fire key, like right mouse button, when you right-click the middlemost block, it digs out one above it and one beneath it. So you could instantly walk forward. Now you have to dig all the three levels of your character's height away. Like this. Chipping at it. Just like that. And now we've made our way here. Let's leave one more torch there. Check if these have... No, they won't respawn, of course. I don't mind it. It's kind of... I don't know if you consider it cheating when I... Shit, son. When I use the world from my earlier character. I don't think it's cheating. I didn't get any massive advantage over it. I did know a bit of the lay of the land around here, though. But that's all. Let's plunk a... Well, let's plunk one. Down here somewhere. Because I want to take this damn tree down. I can hear jumpies already. Fancy that. I'll check how long I have been recording. I've been going for 10 minutes. And I'll just leave it down so I can see it. You can't, but I can. Because I'm trying to keep these videos in 15 minutes. No one's going to watch my 30-minute videos. I'm looking at you, my own Doom 1 episode 1 playthrough. Not that I mind. I think it's kind of a gimmick that no one really watches my videos. It's all the more obscure if people eventually find these and start watching these. Maybe even enjoy them. I know people who watch these are the few of my real-life friends who might watch this through gritting their teeth together, thinking how this jackass can keep on doing this. Well, I can, bitches, and I will. I'm coming across as overly hostile, I think. But that's who I am, bitch. Oh man, Mr. Levolf. The layer there. It's getting dark, and oh yeah, the reason I'm making this tunnel down is because I want to access the caves down there much faster, so at these levels of platforms I can easily jump to and from. Spooky scary zombies are flocking down there, and I really need to find myself some torches, or gel rather. I'm squinting my eyes and, well, not squinting. My eyes are wide open, I'm staring at the screen, but I can't see nothing. I have to dig a bit here to see. Yeah, that's more like it. Yep. Plunk this one down here. Craft some more. Yep, now we can jump across. See, I'm making this. This will be risky, yeah. So I'm making this when you stand on one and jump to max height. Speak of the devil. When you jump max height, you'll get to the other level. Like this. Fancy. We have a bit of acorns, so I might as well take down this. Plant a new one and hope it grows strong and large like mine. Durr! The absolute worst, and I intend to keep it that way. Plunk him down. Nice little. Oh, I see what you're doing. I'm not even going to bother because it's really hard fighting on elevated ground. Let's see what the guide says. Oh yeah, he does tell this now. What a helpful guy. Weapons and shelter, of course. Oh, it's S key, isn't it? No, I bound it to E. Yep, don't forget to create and place walls. He really doesn't give any insight on what do they actually do. Use a hammer. Yeah. Now that you have some ore, I don't think I do. Son. Oh yeah, I do. A little bit. Sorry for calling you son. He's still Maxwell, but yeah. He's still Maxwell. No one else. I'm just trying to figure out, because it's night. Nighttime is always boring in this game, let's be honest. At least before you get to the higher gears. Like midnight armor and stuff. Before that it's, well, not always and completely suicidal. But it's risky to go outside. As you can see, I've started terraforming the land a bit. I'll make this cliff and expand my house up there. And then make a ladder like this up here on the cliff. So I can have a bit of an overhang. Because I don't like that claustrophobic house already. I know I said I won't be focusing on building, but something's got to be done. Because this shit is unbearable. Running out of wood already. Yep. This will be about this high. needs to be a bit higher. So it reaches, you'll see, the level of the second floor. Another one of these and another one of these. There we go. Let's make also a temporary roof out of dirt. Then break it so we can get inside, then place it again. A bit willy-nilly. Doesn't matter. I hope no one spawns in there though. We could make stone walls. But I'm going to save it. And this takes care of that episode. It's been another 15 minutes of ill and sick, nasty displeasure you'll have to spend with me. And next episode we'll get that one. Thank you very much for watching if you actually did. See you next time.